Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and welcome back. In the last few segments, we discussed two methods to locate a facility, center of gravity method and the Weber method. And in both methods, actually, center of gravity and Weber method, we focused on one factor on the basis of which we found the location of the facility. And that factor was logistics, or you can say transportation cost. And we assume that transportation cost is directly proportional to the product of distance. There are many other factors too, as we saw in the start of this lecture. And those factors are also important to be considered. So we will see two methods in which we can actually consider more than one factor. And these group of methods as a whole actually are called multi-criteria decision-making tools, or MCDM tools, or MCDM methods. So one that we will use is factor rating method. So many of the factors that managers need to consider when evaluating location alternatives are qualitative in nature. Their importance is also highly subjective based on the opinion of who is evaluating them. So an excellent procedure that can be used to give structure to this process, that is actually to give some weight to these qualitative or subjective factors, is called factor rating method. Factor rating can be used to evaluate multiple alternatives based on a number of selected factors. It is valuable because it helps decision makers structure their opinions relative to the factors identified as important. And these are the steps to be followed to use this method. First, identify dominant factors, the factors that are relevant in certain case to decide the location of facility. And if you have too many factors, you may have to shortlist the most important, like proximity to market, access, competition, or whatever are the relevant in a certain scenario. Assign weights to factors reflecting the importance of each factor relative to the other factors. And important point is that the sum of these weights must be 100. So let's suppose you have three factors, F1, F2, and F3. So you have to assign these factor weights with respect to each other, so that the sum of the weights is 1 or 100%. So let's suppose factor 1 is assigned a weight of 20, factor 2 a weight of 30, and factor 3 a weight of 50. So their sum should be 100. Select a scale by which to evaluate each location relative to each factor. A commonly used scale is a 5-point scale, 1 being the poor or worst and 5 being, but it could be a scale ranging from 1 to 10. So 1 to 5 and 1 to 10 are more common scales. Evaluate each alternative relative to each other using the scale selected in step 3. So we have, let's suppose, 3 alternates. So all 3 alternates will be compared with respect to these 3 factors. So that is step number 4. Step number 5 is that for each factor and each location, multiply the weight of the factor by the score for that factor and sum the results for each alternate. So you have to add the product of weight of the factor and score for that factor for a specific location. And select the alternative with the highest score. So let's take a simple example. Antonio is evaluating 3 different locations. 3 alternates are available for his new Italian restaurant. Costs are comparable at all 3 locations. He has identified 7 factors. that he considered important and has decided to use factor rating method to evaluate his three location alternatives based on a 5-point scale, with 1 being poor and 5 excellent. Table on next slide shows Antonio's factors, the weights he has assigned to each factor, as well as the factor score for each factor at each location. Which location is the best? So this is the scenario. There are total these 7 factors, and he has assigned certain weight to each factor. So you can see that in his opinion, the appearance of the facility and proximity to market are the most important factors. And then come, for example, customer parking and access and ease of expansion and competition and labor supply are relatively less important. And some of these weights must be 100. And for each of these factors, he has rated the 3 alternates that he has. So for example, location 1 is best with respect to appearance, but it is relatively poor with respect to proximity to the market and competition. Similarly, with respect to factor 1 appearance, the location 3 is the worst. And for example, location 2 has sort of average scores for most of the factors, but it is the worst option with respect to access. And location 3, for example, is ideal with respect to proximity to the market and competition, but it is not a good option with respect to appearance and ease of expansion. Now we will simply multiply factor weight by factor score at each location. So for example, in first case, we will multiply the factor weight 20 with the score for that factor at location 1. So that is 5. So 20 into 5 will be 100. Similarly, 20 into 3 will be 60, and 20 into 2 will be 40. For factor 2, ease of expansion, so 10 multiplied by 4 will be 40. 10 multiplied by 4 for location 2 will also be 40, and 10 multiplied by 2 will be 20 for location 3, and we can continue in the same manner, 20 into 2, 20 into 3, and 20 into 5, so we will have 40, 60, and 100, and you can continue in the same manner to find the scores for each location with respect to each factor. So just cross-check the calculations so that there is no mistake. So in this case, we had 15 into 5, 15 into 2, and 15 into 3. So 10 into 2, 20, 10 into 4, 40, 10 into 5, 50, and then we have 30, 30, and 40. So I hope the calculations are correct. So now you can simply add the scores for each location and get the gross or total score. So in this case, for location 1, we will have a total score of 380. For location 2, 305, and for location 3, 340. So we can see that as a whole, location 1 is the best option, but you can also see factor by factor. So with respect to factor 1, for example, location 1 is the ideal. With respect to factor 3, location 3 is the best, but we have to make a decision based on the cumulative score. So in that regard, location 1 is the best option. So this is the solution. So we can use Excel actually to solve the same problem. So it is not a very difficult problem, but let's solve it using Excel. So we are given the weights for each factor and score for each location with respect to each factor. We have simply to multiply the two values. So we will multiply, for example, 20 and 5 and simply drag to find the scores for each factors for location 1, and you can simply add these scores to find the total score for location 1. And you can do the same for location 2. So factor score multiplied by the score of location 2 for that factor. Simply you can drag down and find the score for location 2, and you can do the same for location 3. So the best option is the location 1 based on the gross score. So we have used index and match function here to display this name of the ideal location. So if you have any question, you can ask during question answer session.